goes. Rock.
No, music.
Conversation about how we promised not to drop the microphones anymore. 5 minutes long, and she was like, okay, they cost €1,000 a piece, please don't drop the mic anymore.
Hey, I don't. I'm so sorry. You realize that it was inevitable.
It had to happen, and it will probably happen 10 more times during this panel.
Hi, Misha.
Hello, Jensen. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm well.
I did an impression of you earlier.
Did you?
It kind of tanked.
Did it?
Yeah, it wasn't any good.
They didn't think it was funny?
Didn't have legs.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Now,
okay. What?
Like, just roughly speaking, what did the impression look like?
It was,
Let me guess.
Okay.
Kind of, like, macho, right? Like, kind of just, like, tough, kind of badass,
yes.
Is my guess?
Well, it was certainly like a sport involved.
Like...
if you want to call it that. Wait a minute. There are people that call it a sport. There are people that refer to it as a sport.
Is it like something, like a tough sport? Like a kind of, like a manly sport?
Yeah.
Is that sport bicycle touring?
Maybe. I'm not familiar with that sport. What is, yes, it's like sport.
It's very similar to sport.
Yeah. How, by the way, sore at all?
Sore?
Sore?
What? Am I sore?
Sore.
Well, after my panel with Jared, yeah. I'm sorry, you were talking about the bike riding.
No, I was talking about what just happened.
But with the seat and everything as it is, both the panel and the bike hurt me in the same place.
You heard it here first, folks.
Hold on.
Just a minute.
I'm just going to fill them in for like 10 minutes. And just a minute.
Stay tuned for these messages from our sponsors.
I can just tell him on the mic. There was a question that had a little bit of innuendo in it. Where I don't know if you know this, but in Italy, the... they call cum influence. anyway, it's a long story. Whatever. No, not a big deal. Long story short, the question sort of implied that Cass was the bottom in the relationship. With Sam. And it got pretty graphic.
So it's like in football, there's you have your offensive line,
yep.
You have your like tailbacks, you have a quarterback,
yep.
You have a receiver. I get it. There's also a tight end.
I hate sports analogies.
Tight end.
Sam.
We should take questions.
Yeah, let's take some questions.
We should take some questions. Hi, lovely.
Hello.
Mike.
Okay, now
there you go.
Hello, guys.
Hi.
Yeah. This is a serious question. I'm Italian and it's not. And not about influence.
This is a serious question.
Okay.
Is that going to be our code word for a question about sex from now on?
For both of you.
Okay. So we should probably establish a safe word at this point. Minus keep going.
Okay, we all know you from what we have seen and see in screens and at conventions, but I was wondering if you could tell us a unique story that belongs just to the real.
Why are you yelling at us? You're so loud. Okay, go
on. I'm a little bit nervous, I'm sorry. Okay, if you could tell us just a unique story,
yes.
That belongs just to the real Jensen and the real Misha,
yes.
That you have never told to anyone, in order to let us know a little bit better. Know you a little bit better.
We have to dust off some of the stories that we usually try not to tell other people.
I feel like those stories happen. They get told naturally, like through it's trying a, to. It just they kind of. I can't just. I don't. It's like oh.
Let me tell you the story that we've never told anyone.
There you go. Here's a real gem. I don't have that. I'm not. We're not Richard and Rob. We can't. I guess we could do a Richard and Rob.
Maybe, which is the most weird question that a fan ever asked you?
The last question that we got.
Yeah, just that.
From
that
microphone.
Previous question was, I think it started with, this is a serious question.
I'm still racking my brain, I'm trying to think of something.
you're actually trying to think of like some crazy story right now.
Maybe just an ordinary story.
Just a generic story?
Yes.
Just there was
once
many, many moons ago, when we were just
many moons ago, my name's Mark Shepard.
Hello, how are you?
I told you this, right? I told them that I wouldn't read the script, I read it aloud.
Yeah.
And then and Mark's Crowley's lines are read in a very Monty Python-esque.
We should make him do that on the show.
Well, he does. That's how I hear it. And I, you know what? I actually have a voice for you.
What is that voice? Never mind. Asked that of honest, open curiosity, and then the minute the question came out of my mouth, I was like, "That's gonna make fun of me."
I'm gonna find a script. You tell a story that okay. dust off an old story for.
Oh. Well, I will share this with you. This is a sort of a generalization about our private interactions. And I don't know that I've shared this before, so I think
Oh, shit.
We spent a lot of time in Cliff's car. Driving from our trailers to set, back again. And we have often remarked on how we have a lot of, like, it's our time to sort of have deep conversations, talk about issues that are important to us. And we've often commented on the fact that any randomly selected 15-second portion of that conversation would ruin all of our careers forever if it went public. We make a lot of very dirty jokes, say a lot of things that shouldn't be said by human beings. We laugh. We think it's funny. You're having a hard time finding a script that has Castiel in it, aren't you?
I am. Hey, how about this? How about this? What's an episode this season? Think of a scene this season between Dean and Castiel. What is it? On the phone. On the phone of baby? Gotcha. That was 11:04. It was 11:04. Hold on. Blue script revisions.
Yeah, make sure you get the blue revisions. I don't want to do the production draft. That's going to cost you a lot of money.
No, it's not. You know what? I have a grandfathered clause plan on my phone.
What?
Yes.
And I am going to tweet to AT&T right now.
Do it.
And tell them.
Because Jared, when we were in London 2 weeks ago, Jared's like, hey, dude, you might want to call your carrier and make sure that you've got an international plan, because you're going to get dinged on the data and the texts and the voicemail and stuff. And I was like, I think I'm covered, but you're making me nervous. So I'm going to go ahead and call. So I called with him sitting right next to me, and I called.
That must have made him so mad.
And I just put on speaker. I'm like, hey, it's like, hi, you know, hi, this is Jeffrey from AT&T. How can I help you? He's like, hey, so I just wanted to know if I'm in England right now. I need to put an international plan. I'm going to be in Rome in 2 weeks. We just want to make sure that, you know, everything's copacetic. And he was like, actually, you're good worldwide. You have a grandfather plan.
That must have made Jared so
angry. He was irate. He was so angry. And I just went like this. I was like, oh, thanks, Jeff.
Thanks, Jeff. Jared recently had an argument with AT&T that sort of took over.
Oh, they know.
Took over the internet. And it also, it wound up with like the office of the president of AT&T reaching out to Jared to make sure that they had satisfied all of his concerns. And everybody in the cast and crew spent about 3 days talking to Jared about his AT&T plan. Like, it was serious business around the set. So Jared probably lost 3 days of sleep over that phone call that Jensen had.
Yeah, he's not happy. All right, I got it.
Okay, I'll just read it over your shoulder.
So, I'm going to read.
I'll read the other parts. So that
No. I'm telling you, this is how I read it when I'm reading it.
Oh, you're going to read myself. All of the parts?
I read all the parts.
Oh, well, fuck. I'll go home. Do you want your apple juice?
So, yeah.
I don't know which one.
This is really well-aged apple juice.
They used to disguise it by putting it in a coffee cup.
Okay, so let's see. Scene 19. Interior Impala. Parked, field, day, flashback.
I'm actually nervous right now.
Through one of the windows, we see Dean out of fed threat. Now, normally, and I don't know why, and I have no idea why, but when I'm comfortable and I'm sitting on my couch and I'm reading my script, I read all of the stage direction in an Aussie accent.
Well, we're gonna have to hear that.
Through one of the windows,
Through one of the windows, we see Dean out of the fed threads and in the cities now, walking through a field by a forest. In the foreground, we see his cell phone on the Impala's dash. The phone rings, caller ID, it's Cass. Dean reacts. Hearing the phone, he heads over back to the car. Note, in this scene, the phone is a character. The prop is Cass. So, we can cut back to the shots of the phone as if Cass is in the car the whole time. Dean picks up the phone, puts it on speaker. Cass? More coughing from Cass. Hey man, you okay?
I'm mostly confused. I'm not sure how the orange collates the black in a way that's new.
Okay, step away from the Netflix.
Sorry.
It's okay, we've all had a binge. You find anything in the lore?
There is a creature that feeds on hearts and blood.
A werepire, you might want to say. Come on, no, you want to say it.
In lore, it's referred to as the Whisper.
I have to hand it to you, it's pretty spot on. It's pretty good. I didn't know where you were going with that, but you nailed it. Next question, yeah.
Hi. Guys, you are good actors. You are good singers.
Did you just pay attention? Were you watching that last bit?
You are good dancers.
Were they all singing,
can
all
you
dancing?
Dance for us?
She thinks that she can compliment us into
dancing,
being dancing monkeys.
No, but I'll tell you what. Misha and I will write a song for you real quickly. You wanted to know about dancing?
Yeah.
What else did you want to know about?
I don't know.
Three words.
I don't know.
Just three words. Just say three things that come to mind.
By the way, I want to go on the record as saying that I feel like Jensen is painting us into a corner here.
No, we're good. This is going to be good.
Jensen Bellocom, fun, and love.
All right.
Okay.
So the good news is I have to put this down to play the guitar, so you're...
I stand corrected. He's painting me into a corner.
You're smart. You think on your feet. You make brilliant videos, put them on Facebook, write amazing texts and tweets and stuff. Go ahead. Spit out some lyrics, big
guy. Okay. I'll hold your mic for you.
She said, hey, let's get our mellow on. She said, hey, where is the photo op? Oh yeah, I've got a guy to grope. It's Justin Bellocom. It's just a mellow con. We'll get our mellow on. I don't know why I picked those words.
Now would be the time to drop the mic. Don't do it! Don't do it! You're welcome.
Thank you.
Have that woman removed from.
Yeah, if we could just go.
Put her on the do not return list.
That one out. That would be. Just go back and retape. We're gonna go back and retape that.
Yeah. Hi.
Hi. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I wanted first of all to thank you about creating the You Are Not Alone campaign and the Supernatural Crisis Support Network, because just the fact that you thought of us like that, it's amazingly thoughtful and awe-inspiring, and it's why I and we all love you.
Thank you.
In last season, Dean confessed that there's people and feelings that he would like to experience differently, even for the first time. And this season, settling down has come up so many times. And I was just wondering if you think that Dean can ever combine a hunting and a romantic relationship in a way. And for you, Misha, if Cass could have like something in between normal and supernatural and stuff.
Are you talking about the work-home life balance and how we need to strike a better one in Supernatural?
Why not?
You're asking if Dean's ever going to have an actual relationship?
To combine, like, because I don't think he will ever get away from hunting altogether.
No. However, if there was a huntress, you guys would kill her. So, no. I'm destined to a life of solitude.
Thanks
a
lot.
And thank you very much.
That's true. You could have been shooting a lot of really steamy sex scenes over the years if it weren't for these fuckers.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. No, there could have been a lot of serious questions asked. And a lot of influence.
You guys have a lot of influence. You don't know how much influence you have. You just gotta tap into it.
You just found the line.
Cross that one. Jared and I kept on pushing the mic down during our panel for exactly that reason.
Thank you, Will.
Hi.
Hi. I was just wondering if, well, this question's for both of you, but if you guys could do a movie together, any movie, what would
Harry
you
Met Sally.
I'll have what he's having.
Yes.
Hi. This question is about the Supernatural.
Really, we're going with what Harry Met Sally?
Got chucks on with Saint Laurent. Gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too high.
All right, are we done with that? Is that okay? Yeah. Nothing like watching a couple white guys dance on a stage. That's...
So, hey.
God.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Nope.
When did we pass our prime? Because it definitely happened at some point in the past if we're doing that now. That is what people who are trying to cling to a former success do. That is...
Where was the success? When did it happen?
I don't
know. And when did it leave us?
I don't know. That's what I'm asking. Did we ever have any success, or was it all in our heads?
I think at the point where you were reading my resume and I was reading your resume.
We had a point when we were taking photos earlier where I was holding an ice cream cone that he was licking. And I thought to myself, gosh, this isn't what I imagined it was gonna be like.
And then just to dab a little salt in the wound.
We had an amazing photo session, by the way.
Just to dab a little salt in the wound. You know who you are, wherever you are. This lovely young woman walks up and says, I'm gonna be in the middle and you two are my bitches.
That's not the punchline.
The punchline is that me and Misha looked at each other and we went, no argument,
zero.
No hesitation,
no resistance, no,
no resistance at all, just, yeah.
We get it.
And then she walked away and he looked at me and softly said to me, that's where we are now.
What's it like to be on a long-running, successful show? Well, let me tell you.
It's when the fans really respect you, love you, adore you, admire you, and walk up to you and say, you two are the bitches in this one.
In the same photo session, we had a piece of candy, string candy, that went from... The idea, it was like a Lady and the Tramp kind of photo, right? And so we had
our... You know who you are!
We had our respective ends near our mouths, and the woman standing between us said, eat it. And then she repeated, eat it. And so we did.
We often get questions, what's the weirdest thing a fan's asked you to do? These are those moments. Now, I will say that most of that photo session, I would say 99% of that photo session, was very enjoyable. You people are fucking awesome. However, playing Lady and the Tramp and acting like bitches, that's not on the resumes we read years ago.
No. We have to add that now to our resumes.
So now we get to add that into our special, what is it?
Special skills.
Special skills. Bitches.